Canada's quarterly award has now had its first winner. It aims to give recognition to employees who have made a significant contribution to their company's business, whether that has been introducing an innovative idea or having been outstanding in customer relations. Such nominations also say much for the nominating company too. There are substantial prizes for the award winner, so find out more. Contact North Sound on Aberdeen 33 7000.
With a him and a... Margaret closes her eyes and prays for mercy. After dropping through the air like a stone, the parachute opens and Sister Margaret and Derek glide gracefully back down to Earth. Let's see those wimps from VR troopers do that, she boasts after landing. Sister Margaret, you are one brave little nun!
You've been watching Fox Kids. Tune in tomorrow morning from 6 for more of your favourite shows.
Teenage champions, G-Force, guardians of space, fighting for good over evil, fighting to defend planet Earth from deadly enemy space. Ace Goodheart, leader of the team, strong, vigilant, fearless as a hawk, guarding the four young agents under his command. Dirk Daring, second in command, a crack marksman with the eye of an eagle and nerves of steel. Agatha June flies like a dove, strikes like a falcon. A match for the strongest on the team. Hoodow, hoodie to his friends. Wisecracking navigator who flies the amazing rocket ship Phoenix and laughs at danger. Pee-wee, small and bold as a merlin, the tiniest hawk of them all. These are the adventures of G-Force. Five secret agents trained to fly like birds. G-Force, guardians of space.
As night falls over a harbor, a freighter appears, unaware of danger ahead.
Hey, there's a hubbub on deck. What's going on there?
Ah, the men are excited. They're just happy to be back from the sea.
Look, what is that?
Holy smoke, it looks like a tidal wave.
That's impossible. The sea is calm.
It'll tear us apart. It's coming right up on the ship.
It's about to smash our bow. Oh.
Moments later, Ace Goodheart, Agent One and leader of G-Force, returns from patrol, sensing that something has gone wrong.
What's that? Holy smoke, half the city's on fire! This. This is Agent One. I read you.
This is Dr. Benjamin Brighthead calling to inform you that the bridge over the strait and the petrochemical works have been destroyed.
I know, Dr. Brighthead. I'm flying over those positions now.
Incredible as it sounds, witnesses say those positions were attacked by a giant whale.
Giant whale. That means it's Galactor's work, isn't it?
Maybe. But acting on that assumption, Ace, transform and join your squad.
Yes, sir. G-Force, transform!
The amulet transforms Ace. It beams him and the rest of G-Force aboard the rocket ship Phoenix.
Ace, are you telling us that the damage done at the harbor was caused by a whale?
Reliable observers reported it was a whale, Pee-wee, but of course it must have been a submarine in the shape of a whale.
In other words, Ace, you're convinced it's the work of Galactor.
That's just the way you'd expect that monster to destroy Earth.
Right, Aggie, and we've got to stop him before he does.
There's a herd of whales! Sure enough, those are real whales, all right.
Yeah, and notice how they're swimming straight ahead in formation, almost as if they're aiming for something.
You know, whales are reported to have very good hearing. Their ears are as sensitive as radar.
Mm-hmm. I've heard that too, Hootie.
All right, let's drop down, track those whales, and see exactly where they're heading.
The Phoenix skims the waves, with Hoot Owl recalling Dr. Brighthead's words.
Whales have very sensitive ears. They can hear extremely high frequencies.
Suffering sea serpents, that's gotta be the biggest whale ever born.
Right on, Dirk Daring.
And all the other whales are heading for it. Something about it attracts them. Let's get close to it, but be careful. For trouble. Stay on its tail.
It's attacking the real whales!
Mother whale's baby.
Ace, is that baby whale gonna be an orphan?
Too soon to tell, Pee-wee.
Oh.
What are we gonna do about that big whale submarine?
Track it, Dirk, and find out what Galactor's up to.
Yeah, and get even with him for what he did to those whales.
What are those?
They're killer whales, the wolves of the sea, probably coming to attack the injured whales.
Oh, they might attack the baby whale. We have to help it out.
Can't, Pee-wee. You mustn't forget we're on a mission.
But if we turn our back on it, that baby whale is surely a goner, right?
And if we let that sub escape, we help Galactor.
That whale is a living thing, don't forget. Look, Dirk, I'm not abandoning that little baby whale, and that's final.
Hey, Pee-wee, where are you going?
What good does that little punk think he can do with a small shuttle? Huh?
I think I know.
Those killer whales are attacking! I have to stop them! Not a bad catch!
The Phoenix returns to its secret base at the bottom of the sea.
Look at Pee-wee, riding the baby whale in the ship's dome. Stand by, everyone. We're at the base. Take her in, Hootie, steady as she goes.
Do you realize what you've done? Hmm? While you were all busy caring for a baby whale, you let the worst enemy the planet Earth has slip right through your fingers. And now we're receiving data from nations all over the world that their largest ports are under attack. Their harbors are being smashed by giant whales.
Well, Dr. Brighthead, is there any question that those giant whales are giant submarines belonging to Galactar?
We don't know, Ace. We lost the clue while you were chasing that baby whale. That was a kind thing of you to do, Pee-wee, but I've set the baby whale free.
What? Why'd you do that, Doctor?
He's going to help us, Pee-wee. I attached a direction finder to him.
A direction finder to find what, sir?
The whale's brain capability will be put to practical use. He'll lead us to something, which is more than the five of you did. Sorry, but you're G-Force, and you have a mission.
Look! The path that's appearing on radar is changing.
Mm-hmm. The baby whale's following that submarine to the Arctic Circle. You can bet there's something going on up there.
There are some areas up there that are many miles of deep glacier where neither man nor beast has set foot right to this time, Pee-wee.
That's right, Ace, and that's an ideal place for Galactor to set up a secret base to use in his plot to destroy the Earth. G-Force, you leave at once for the Arctic Circle!
Roger!
From the baby whale's direction finder show we're directly above him.
Funny. That baby whale is doing nothing more than circling around under some floating ice. Ace, what is that?
I don't know, Dirk, but we're going down to check it out.
I think you'd better come with me, Dirk. And you three had better wait here.
I think you better take me.
Oh, now don't you be difficult, Pee-wee.
Who's difficult?
What a weird-looking base camp.
Shh, that's radar working. It can pick up every sound, even a low whisper.
Why would a shack like that have such advanced radar?
Well, let's see.
We mean you no harm. We just happened to stumble in.
We're Hudson Bay Rangers. We were checking on some polar bears. We just happened to lose our way. You see, we tried to contact our base by radio, and then the darn radar began to work. I tried to stop it.
That's so? Well, maybe we can help you two fellas out. Right, Dirk?
That's right.
Hold it! Galactor's men. I'm not surprised. I knew there was something suspicious about them. Now look, my friend, don't you be too tough on yourself. These guys strike from behind. They're bad eggs. They finished off my parents the same way. A pair of ruthless gangsters.
Gotcha.
Huh? Huh?
Guard, you haven't checked in for over half an hour. Everything okay?
Yeah, okay.
Wow. Ace, we'd better tell the others what's been going on up here.
G1 calling G3. Come in, G3.
G3 here. What's up, G1?
You and Pee-wee come over here right away and bring a counter-direction finder.
Calling me at last. They need my talented touch.
Keep an eye on things, will you, Hootie?
I'm always left out.
Ha! If you had my talent, they'd be calling you too.
Yeah.
T-minus 20. Get those missiles aboard the submarines.
Submarine base. What's the problem, guard?
What's the problem? Hello?
The finder works even when they put the phone down.
What up?
I don't know. Guard put the phone down without saying one word, Lieutenant.
Strange. Well, keep an eye on things. I'll report to Galactor.
Hurry, Agatha.
Aggie.
Okay, Aggie, please hurry.
It's on. The depth of the sea beneath us is about 100 feet.
Roger.
Now this little beauty, the rocket mole.
Ah, it's a soft bottom. This may go a lot faster than we thought.
Like cutting through melted butter.
Okay, I'll go first. This is a pretty large-scale operation.
Oh, great Galactor, the Lieutenant reporting. All is ready.
Very well, have the submarines depart at once. Destroy all the ports in the world.
There is no time to lose. Aggie, hand out the exploding darts.
Roger.
All right, let's get started. Set each dart in the spot where it'll do the most good.
Roger.
Roger. Remember, everyone, these darts explode 10 minutes after they're set.
We've got to finish in 5 minutes to give ourselves time to get out.
T-minus 10.
Who's there? That's cute. A baby whale.
The direction finder.
Hey. That whale is bugged.
What was that?
Trouble.
All guards to the submarine base.
Oh, you dumbbell, get the heck out of here! This whole place is about to blow up. Now you get out of here! Hey, look, you did your job well. Thank you. Now will you please get out of...
Pee-wee, what are you doing? We have to move out.
I know, but we can't just leave this baby here.
Look, if we don't move out, we'll be blown apart.
Great Galactor, G-Force has penetrated our ranks.
I hold you personally responsible for this, Lieutenant.
Yes, Your Excellency.
If my plan to blow up the ports is spoiled, you will pay the price.
I understand.
That's it. Our time has run out.
Listen, you two get back to the Phoenix, okay? Get going!
And what about you?
Bye!
Pee-wee!
To the ship!
What about Pee-wee?
There
There's no time. Fly!
Lower all submarines. Prepare to strike. Now! The G-Force ship is the Phoenix. Find it!
The Phoenix!
Get us out of here fast, Hootie. She's wide open now, Ace.
Those darts will explode in 1 minute more.
I know.
Hey, Galactor submarines are underway!
We have to clear out of here fast. The darts attached. Those fake whales are set to detonate at any second now.
That's right. Hootie, take us in closer to the whales.
What are you saying? If we get closer, we'll get ripped apart when those whales explode.
We've got to lure them away from Pee-wee on the base.
Lieutenant, G-Force is coming to attack.
Good. Tell the other ship. We'll blast G-Force from the skies.
Even if he did, Aggie, how could he possibly withstand the freezing temperatures of the Arctic Ocean up there?
Well, I guess I gotta say thanks to you for saving my life. We punished those bad people who injured your mother and those other whales. Learn to be brave even if you're alone. Bye! Pee-wee, ready to report for duty. You guys okay?
Yeah, we're okay. Get back here, kid. We're off on another mission.
And so they are. Wherever you find the ruthless Galactor ready to strike, there you'll find G-Force.
Stand by. Let battle commence. Robotech downloads next.
Bloomberg's Richard Salamat talked about the special appeal of Tuscany to Marialina Marcucci, Vice President of the Tuscan Region and the Regional Minister for Culture. We'll be right back.
Five teenage champions, G-Force, guardians of space, fighting for good over evil, fighting to defend planet Earth from deadly enemies from space. Ace Goodhart, leader of the team, strong, vigilant, fearless as a hawk, guarding the four young agents under his command. Dirk Daring, second in command, a crack marksman with the eye of an eagle and nerves of steel. Agatha June, flies like a dove, strikes like a falcon, a match for the strongest on the team. Hoodow, hoodie to his friends, wisecracking navigator who flies the amazing rocket ship Phoenix and laughs at danger. Pee-wee, small and bold as a Merlin, the tiniest hawk of them all. The adventures of G-Force, five secret agents trained to fly like birds. G-Force, guardians of space.
Galactor, I approve your design for the giant crab beast.
Thank you, Computor. I plan to utilize it as soon as the final tests are complete.
No! There is no reason to wait. You need to replenish our uranium supplies. You must attack the World Uranium Warehouse at once. You do agree?
Yes, but I want to make sure of success.
It cannot fail.
How can you be sure?
I am Computor.
Maybe I should have more faith in my work.
Believe you cannot win, and you will fail.
But I know that I can win. The problem is that somehow G-Force always manages to foil my schemes. But with the capabilities of the giant crab, I should be able to correct that. The first assignment will be to capture enough uranium to fuel the giant crab. That way I will keep my fighters active. All fighters will proceed to the world's uranium storage warehouse. Bring the uranium back.
Battle stations! Battle stations! All pilots report to your plane! The uranium storage warehouse is under attack!
There they are! Begin firing! Fire at will!
The men to go in for the uranium. Their defense is defeated. Oh? Lieutenant, our fuel is running short.
Then retreat to the giant crab for refueling.
Strange. Night fishing is when we usually catch the most fish. There must be something that's scaring the fish tonight. What do you say we give it one more pass, and if nothing bites, we'll pack it in, call it a day?
Huh? There's something in the water.
What do you mean?
That crab's huge.
Look up. It's a squadron of Galactor's jet fighters.
What do you think they're up to?
The crab must be some kind of refueling depot. Huh? Ah!
Sorry I have to cut our holiday short. I've just received a distress alert from the United World Air Force. Galactor has designed another weapon, a giant crab that attacked the uranium storage warehouse. This giant crab also serves as a refueling depot, so it has a Galactor fighter squadron with it at all times. It's essential we destroy it.
Roger!
Ace, patrol high altitude. See if you can spot it. Dirk, cover the mountains. Aggie, you watch the coast. Pee-wee, take the foothills. And if you see Hootie, put him on alert.
Huh? Hey, watch out!
Hootie, come on! You gotta come with me, it's father!
What are you talking about? What do you mean, it's father? You're acting strange!
You gotta come, our father's in trouble!
What disaster? Tell me what happened, Sonny!
He went out fishing last night, and on his way back, his ship mysteriously disappeared! There's a search party out looking for him right now, but they haven't
we'll
found him yet!
We'll find him, don't worry!
You gotta help us!
Huh? This is Hootie, Dr. Brighthead.
Hootie, where have you been? I've been looking everywhere. You're supposed to keep your radio on. I need you in the Phoenix now.
I'm sorry, I was sleeping. Be right there. Sonny, I can't come right now. You'll have to go back by yourself, all right?
Huh? What are you telling me? Hootie, Papa's life could depend on it. You gotta come, you just gotta come.
I can't come now. Please, go back by yourself.
What exactly is more important than saving your father's life? It's your responsibility to come with me and help him now! You can't be my brother or else you would help me find father! I hate you, Hootie!
Lieutenant, why are you not attacking the enemy? I want their uranium supply and I want it now!
Yes, sir. Have all pilots stand by to launch.
Roger.
Ace to G-Force vehicles. Attention all vehicles.
I've located Galactor's crab weapon. It's headed for the uranium supply. Proceed there at top speed.
Great, we found it. Let's see if it's as fierce as Dr. Brighthead says.
Battle stations! Battle stations! Airborne crab robot approaching north by northwest.
Take the uranium and destroy the warehouse.
Lieutenant, G-Force has been spotted.
Good, then we'll be able to crush them as well.
Here they come now. Everyone rendezvous with the Phoenix and we'll destroy them before they can get started.
But Hootie's not here.
What do you mean? Where is he?
But wait, Hootie! You can't just run away and forget about your father.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sonny. You just don't understand. Father, forgive me!
Well, if the Phoenix isn't here, we'll just have to fight them with the weapons we've got.
All right, Ace.
This will be more of a challenge than I thought.
Oh, that's the warehouse!
Got to save that warehouse! Sorry, Dr. Brighthead. Galactor's men just plain overpowered us.
I know how you feel, Ace, but it wasn't your fault. Besides, you'll be glad to know Galactor wasn't very successful. He got away with some of the uranium, but not much.
Yes, but if Hootie had been there with the Phoenix as he was supposed to be, then we would have been able to stop them, sir.
Sorry.
You failed your friends whom you've sworn to protect.
Dirk, what's done is done. We must now concentrate on the problem that lies ahead of us all.
Right. I've never seen Hootie like this.
According to my best calculations, Galactor's crab warship is aiming to attack the world uranium tanker that's headed for storage plant 19.
Hootie, I'll set the coordinates.
And I'll set up the bird missile. That way it'll be ready to fire when we get there.
Dirk, I want to fire the bird missile at them this time, just once.
It isn't a child's toy, Pee-wee.
How can you forget about your father?
Hootie!
I'll save you, Dad, I will. First, I've got to help G-Force get Galactor, or we're all finished. Hang on, Dad, hang on!
What about that tanker? See if you have a visual on it. We should be just about on it by now.
I don't see a thing, and radar's a big zero. Aggie, check your position.
Okay. Wait a minute, we're off course. We've got to be 100 miles south.
What? Hootie, what's the matter with you anyway? Answer me!
I'm sorry, Ace, I don't know.
Ace, what are you doing out there? While you've been flying around, Galactor's managed to destroy the tanker. Well, don't just sit there. Get going. Hurry.
This is all my fault. I don't know what happened.
Forget about it. Just get us over there.
Roger.
Help!
You failed, Hootie.
Galactor!
I am sorry I did not have a chance to destroy you at the last battle, yet I have known all along that you are nothing but cowards. I thought you might like to know that with my latest victory, I have replenished my uranium supply, and with the aid of the giant crab, my plan of conquering Earth is finally within my grasp. Behold the face of destiny!
No, Galactor will never be master of this planet!
Galactor isn't even fit to rule over mangy dogs!
Hootie, your performance has become irresponsible and totally, totally unacceptable. You are the best navigator we've got, but lately you've been acting as if Galactor's activities are nothing more than a game to you. I don't know what your problem is, Hootie, that's your business, but besides allowing Galactor to escape with our precious uranium, you've also endangered the lives of your comrades, the same lives that you've sworn to protect.
But he never meant to endanger any of our lives, Doctor.
This is a matter between Hootie and me. It's not your affair.
I must disagree with you, sir. You see, there's no distinction between us. What you say to one of us, you say to all of us. We respect and rely on your leadership, but we're the ones who put our lives on the line. The guy who stands beside me is as much a part of me as my own right arm is.
Ace, Dr. Brighthead is right. I failed. You could have all been killed, and it would have been my fault. I resign my commission in G-Force, Dr. Brighthead. I'm going back to being a simple fisherman.
No, you'll do no such thing. When I want your resignation, I'll ask for it. Until then, you remain here and wait for further orders.
Whatever you say.
Aggie?
What, Ace?
Was it wrong to defend Hootie?
Not at all, but the way you did it made Dr. Brighthead feel alienated from us.
He was laying it on pretty thick, and Hootie was feeling bad enough already.
Perhaps, but Hootie is acting strange.
I know.
He seems to be preoccupied with something far away.
Well, what are we going to do about it, Aggie? I hate to see him go on like this.
We've got to confront him and make him talk this out. That's the only thing we can do.
Anyone see a guy called Hootie?
You know Hootie?
He should know Hootie, Aggie. That's Hootie's brother, Sonny. Why, I haven't seen you since you were little. What are you doing out here?
I'm trying to find Hootie, that's all, sir. Our father's missing at sea, and I need Hootie's help to find him, and that's why.
What? Your father is missing? Well, that certainly would explain things.
We have to find my father.
Don't worry, Sonny. I have friends in the World Air Force. They'll help us look for him.
Really?
Sure they will.
Why, your father is as good as found right now.
You guys are swell.
Hootie, are you gonna sit there like a sick cow forever? Get up, or maybe your father's life isn't so very important to you after all.
What?
Yes, we all know your father is missing.
That's right, and we've decided the only thing to do is to go out and find him before it's too late.
With or without the doctor's permission.
But we can't take the Phoenix out without any kind of authorization.
I'll take the responsibility. Besides, you're going to be a nervous wreck. That is, until you know that your father is safe.
We need you working at 100% if we're going to have any chance at all of defeating this crab weapon.
But what if Galactor attacks us while we're out on a search and rescue mission?
Then we'll teach him that G-Force is the greatest fighting team around.
Well...
What are we waiting for? Let's go!
Roger! Roger.
Dr. Brighthead calling G-Force. Do you read? Over.
We read.
Uh-oh. We're really in big trouble now, guys.
Hello, G-Force. I thought you might benefit from some information I have that may enable you to locate Hootie's father a little bit faster. A fishing vessel was reported destroyed in the vicinity of Robert Islands. I suggest you concentrate your search there. Don't think for a minute, though, that I have any intention of approving your action.
Huh? We weren't fooling him for a minute, Hootie. He knew exactly what we were all up to. You know, the Robert Island Group is one of the largest in the world. It consists of thousands of small islands spread out over miles. Hootie, it's like looking for a needle in a haystack.
If we have to search every island, this is going to take us about 2 years, Hootie.
No, Dirk.
He's alive. I know he is.
I'm sure he is. After all, he's a man trained to live on the sea. Why, he's got to be out relaxing on some beach.
Can't you be serious about anything?
Hey! Over there! Smoke!
That's got to be it.
We found it!
Hey, over here!
That's my father!
Thank you for saving us. We had just about given up hope. If you hadn't seen our signal fire, we'd have perished for certain. Tell me, are you the famous space guardians we've heard so much about?
Yes, sir.
You young people certainly are brave. You know I have a son your age, but he's not brave like you. He's good at one thing, eating.
My father mustn't know that I'm a member of G-Force, too. It would be too dangerous for him and Sonny if Galactor ever found out. I wish I could tell him. He made me worry about him so much, but now he's safe, and that's what's important, I guess.
Say, fella, are you a member of G-Force as well?
Yes, sir, I am. I'm in charge of navigating the Phoenix for G-Force.
Then you're the one I should be talking to. When my ship was sunk by Galactor, I noticed a giant crab ship you should be able to destroy by attacking its underside.
The World Air Force has been notified of your position and will be here in an hour. Just be patient for a little while longer. This is Agent One.
Ace, I've just received an urgent distress call from Uranium Storage Warehouse number 14, Galactor.
Coming with the Phoenix, sir.
Then launch the fighters. They'll destroy the Phoenix.
Closer, Hootie. I'll destroy them with the bird missile. What are you doing? I had them in my sights.
Be patient, Dirk. They're not about to escape destruction. Besides, we got bigger fish to fry.
As I suspected, they're afraid to fight.
Should I go for the uranium?
Yes, Sergeant. Go in for the uranium.
Hey, G-Force attacking our rear.
Huh? Turn around and we'll fight.
Nice big target, that is. This should be a piece of cake. What are you doing? Let me fire.
I'll fire this one. The underbelly.
Now destroy them with the death ray.
Lieutenant, what do we do?
Why, you coward. Get back to your post and fight.
That's their missile.
It's gonna explode!
go! Get back to your post and fight, you coward! Hey, now, wait for me! Whoa!
What are you doing, you fool?
Excuse me, we're about to be destroyed.
That was great shooting, Hootie. A real bullseye. What about those planes? We haven't won yet.
Have patience and watch what happens now.
Now attack the Phoenix and make sure that it doesn't get away. Huh? Out of fuel.
No fuel, no attack.
Dad! You're safe! I was so worried about you.
Look, Sonny, up there. It's G-Force. They're the ones responsible for saving our lives.
Yes, Dad, I know. So long, G-Force! Thank you!
Yes, thank you, G-Force. What a brave bunch you are. If only my son Hootie had the courage that you have.
If only my father knew.
Well done, G-Force. You'll be glad to hear that the world's uranium supply is once again safe from Galactor. For the time being, that is.
All right, Hootie. Take her home.
Sure, Ace. My pleasure.
7-5 in today's semi-final, and he'll defend his title against Carol Kuchera. Greg Rosetsky, meanwhile, got a win under his belt at the Koyung Classic in Melbourne. After two successive defeats, Rosetsky overcame the Austrian Thomas Muschter 6-3, 7-6.
G-Force! Five teenage champions. G-Force, guardians of space, fighting for good over evil, fighting to defend planet Earth from deadly enemies from space. Ace Goodheart, leader of the team, strong, vigilant, fearless as a hawk, guarding the four young agents under his command. Dirk Gehring, second in command, a crack marksman with the eye of an eagle and nerves of steel. Agatha June, flies like a dove, strikes like a falcon, a match for the strongest on the team. Hoodow, Hootie to his friends, wisecracking navigator who flies the amazing rocket ship Phoenix and laughs at danger. Pee-wee, small and bold as a merlin, the tiniest hawk of them all. These are the adventures of G-Force. Five secret agents trained to fly like birds. G-Force, guardians of space.
G-Force. Monte Diodo is one of the most beautiful countries in the world. It's so small that you can hardly find it on a map, but it is home to one of Europe's most famous auto races, the Monte Diodo Grand Prix. Every year, the top drivers of the world come together in this tiny kingdom to race its city streets and mountain roads in the most dangerous and exciting race of the year. Only the best racing driver in the world can win this event, but anyone brave enough to try is welcome to drive with the best. The name Monte Diodo means Mountain of Gold, and that's a good name for this country because every year, millions of tourists spend millions of dollars at its famous night spots and attractions. With all this money, you'd expect that all the citizens would be rich and happy, but unfortunately, that's not the case. Away from the bright lights of the main streets are the parts of Monte Diodo that tourists never see. Citizens of Monte Diodo suffer terrible poverty, even though their government is so rich. Where does all the government's money go? Well, not too long ago, one brave citizen decided to find out for himself.
Thank you. Hey! Hey, you! Come back! Your legs won't move fast enough to let you escape from Galactor's men.
Trace and report intruder alert.
Unidentified man in record section.
I am sorry for you, Captain, that you have been careless enough to let an outsider find out about this base. You had better launch an investigation immediately.
Yes, mighty Galactor.
You have only raised $4 million for me this week, Your Majesty. Need I remind you of what I can do to your kingdom with just one push of a button?
But I have given you all the money I have. My citizens are starving.
You are the king, aren't you?
Yes.
Then order an increase in taxes immediately.
Oh.
I thought your son, Prince Dominic, had planned to meet us.
That's what he told me he was going to do.
Sorry to keep you waiting, mighty Galactor.
Mind your manners, Dominic.
That's all right. The boy has spirit, and he's going to need a lot of courage if he's going to win this year's Grand Prix, as I've heard he's planning to do.
I'm going to win, all right, Galactor.
I look forward to the race.
Excuse us. Come along.
This black glove is the only evidence we found, sir. The snooper dropped it on the floor of the records room.
I want you to bring me the videotape record of everything that's happened in that room over the past 24 hours.
Just hours later, at the secret underwater base of the International Science Organization, the five members of G-Force were summoned to an emergency meeting by Dr. Benjamin Brighthead.
Good morning, G-Force. I want to thank all of you for coming here on such short notice. I've just gotten an urgent dispatch from Monte Doro, and this information would seem to indicate that Prince Dominic, the heir to the throne of Monte Doro, has been able to acquire secret microfilm maps of the military base that Galactor has built beneath the kingdom.
How can we be sure it's not just a trap?
Our source is very reliable. I was in contact this morning with Prince Dominic himself.
This could be the big chance we've all been waiting for, Ace.
Prince Dominic will be driving in the Monte Doro Grand Prix, which is scheduled for this weekend. The five of you have also been entered as participants in the race.
Hey, does each one of us get to drive our own car?
That's right.
Cool!
This isn't a holiday, Pee-wee. You've got to get us that microfilm. The Prince will be expecting a sign from all five of you before the race starts. By the finish, he should have a chance to hand you the microfilm. And the sooner you can get it back here, the better.
All right, sir.
Dirk, we're counting on you this time.
Don't worry, I'll do my best.
I know. All right, G-Force, there's no time to waste.
Let's go!
Dominic, just as I suspected. It seems the Prince cares more for his puny country than he does for my empire. If those photographs get into the hands of the International Science Organization, G-Force will be able to destroy this base and all my plans for conquering Earth. I'll have to take immediate action to uncover the Prince's plan and stop him. Is that not right, Computor?
Learn to think like your enemies. The Prince is driving in this weekend's race, and he will take that chance to pass the film to a spy from the outside.
Yes, but if I...
If you enter your soldiers in the race, they can just as easily steal the film back.
That is right.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to the event you've all been waiting for. Monte Dioro's own Crown Prince Dominic is the star contender in this year's Grand Prix.
Father, I know that you've tried in your own way to protect our country, but the time has come to fight back against Galactor and his soldiers. This battle belongs to me. I will save Monte Dioro.
As
As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, we have some very unusual overseas entries in this year's event. The Grand Prix route will follow the traditional 3.5 kilometer course through the city and around the mountain. The course must be circled 100 times by the winning driver. Drivers, please take your starting positions.
Film.
Looks like this will be tougher than we thought.
I'm right behind him, Ace.
Hey, everybody, that black car belongs to Galactor. Let's cut him off and get that can of microfilm back.
Roger, Ace.
Hey, this car's getting too hot to handle.
How you doing, Hootie?
I got a little problem with the transmission. You know a good mechanic?
Microfilm back. Aggie and Pee-wee, look after the prince.
I'm right behind him.
Roger!
Let's play that way. We'll take that.
Oh, no, you won't.
Your Highness, you've got to get out of here.
I've never seen that tunnel before.
Ha 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 ha
Well, well, well. What have we here? Welcome, honored guests, and your highness. Prince Dominic, I know that you made microfilm copies of the plans to my secret base. Now I'd appreciate your giving them back.
What makes you think I stole them? It could have been one of your own men.
You left your calling card.
My glove.
I know that you have the microfilm.
Dad!
Your Majesty, you must teach your son to have more discipline.
My son, I don't know what Galactor is asking of you, but you should know by now what the consequences will be if you disobey him.
I know. But sometimes we have to risk our lives for what's right, Father. And this has gone on long enough. Galactor isn't a citizen of Monte d'Oro, and he has no right to our country's money. His reign of terror over our kingdom has to stop.
Dominic, be careful.
I'll do what I have to save my country.
You patriotic fool. Guard!
Mighty Galactor, what are you doing?
I think the prince understands what prize he's playing for. You have 10 seconds to change your mind, Your Highness. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Father, please forgive me. No! Oh, no! Father! What have I done? Father, get him to a hospital!
First, give me the microfilm.
Hey! Watch where you're pointing that thing!
Here, Pee-wee. I got it! I'm a goner!
Get him, guards. At least now we know exactly where the microfilm is hidden.
Whoa! I'm gonna croak! I can't breathe! Oh, no! I can't breathe! Doctor! Brother.
Now that I've got him, what should I do with him?
Take him to surgery and get ready to operate.
Help me find a hollow spot behind this wall. We've got to get out of here in time to stop that operation.
This boot hurts. Hey, look!
It's the microfilm!
Pee-wee must have slipped the film roll into my boot while he was pretending to swallow it.
He sure did a good job of covering up.
Yeah. I sure believe that he swallowed it.
What a brave kid. We gotta rescue him before it's too late.
I think you know what to do, Aggie.
Just leave the rest to me. Good thing I wore my special heels today. That does it. Get ready. Here she blows.
Great!
G-Force, transform!
My stomach ache is all gone.
Be quiet, Doctor. Prepare to operate. I want to have that microfilm within the hour, and I authorize you to do whatever's necessary to get it back. What? G-Force? How did you find out about my secret base?
Oh, we have our ways, Galactor, and you should know by now that you can't hide from us.
I'll take care of them.
Oh, yeah? Chopper!
Right!
Okay, guys, get ready to fly. Now!
Watch out below! All right, Galactor. We have you now. You know, I've always wanted to know what you look like without that mask.
Let me out!
Okay.
Excuse my glove!
Let go of me!
Ah!
okay, Dirk?
Nothing a little chicken soup won't cure.
Good. Then get the microfilm and let's go.
That looks like them, all right. Come in, Ace. This is Hootie, and I'm directly above you.
Galactor's men are right behind us. We need your help.
Roger.
Uh-oh. Gotta fly!
I've lost the microfilm.
Hmm?
Look, there's the boot.
Pretty badly burned, Your Highness. This was going to be a big breakthrough in the fight against Galactor.
We'll have another shot at him.
If I thought this was going to happen, I really would have swallowed it.
Wait a minute. Maybe we can still use it if it wasn't burned all the way through. Let's take it back anyway and see what Dr. Brighthead says.
Yeah, good idea.
Sorry, G-Force. If you think you're going to break into my secret base, you're wrong again. I'll destroy it myself before I let you tear it apart. But don't worry, I can always build another.
Don't you worry, Galactor. We'll find you wherever you go. And so even though the microfilm was destroyed, the peaceful kingdom of Monte D'Oro was freed forever from Galactor's evil grip. Prince Dominic recovered, and G-Force is flying high, defending Earth, guarding space.
Sidekick.
Hey, no problemo, Batman.
If you want the hottest news on Batman...